For centuries, African American farmers have played a huge role in the Midwest. Even before the Civil War, they were responsible for producing a huge portion of the food throughout the region. Dennis Singh traveled to Lyle Station, one of the only remaining settlements. He learned more about these forgotten farmers and the legacy their great-grandchildren are keeping alive.
Driving through the farmlands of southwestern Indiana, you might miss it if you aren't paying attention.
The destination is on your left.
This is Lyle Station, a small farming community in Gibson County, Indiana. So what's so special about this place? To get some answers, I decided to go to school in a classroom set in 1922.
You would have saw students going walking to school, 2.5 miles to school.
This is Stanley Madison, the president and founder of the Lyle Station Historic Preservation Corporation. Madison founded the organization in 1998 to tell the story of Lyle Station.
We feel like that we have been kind of missed on the books as far as for the history of the African American farmers.
The story goes back to the beginning of the 1800s when Americans started seeing opportunities in Midwestern territories, including some Black Americans.
One of our earliest farmers, I guess you might say, was Mr. Charles Greer, and he bought his first 40 acres back in the 1813, before we even became a state in 1816.
More than 20 African American farming settlements sprung up in the area founded by Black pioneers.
South of us here, that's the Sand Hill area, and then off to the northeast over by Patoka River, that was the Roundtree.
And then there's Lyle Station, one of the central settlements where food was produced, collected, and distributed around the country. But this wasn't just a checkpoint for agriculture. Lyle Station also played a role in the Underground Railroad, a gateway to freedom for those who made it across the Ohio River.
Some people would come and stay 3 to 5 years, and then may stay 10 years, and then after they kind of got on their feet, then they moved and migrated on up through Indiana, up in the edge of Michigan.
Lyle Station is also where Stanley's great-grandparents, the Madisons, chose to settle.
This is Jasper and Lydia. We were one of the early families that came to this location.
Stanley was born and raised at Lyle Station, his love of farming passed down to him by his grandfather.
When I was in the seventh grade, he handed me a little 45-pound female pig.
But over the years, many of these settlements started disappearing. Lyle Station is the only remaining African-American farming settlement in Indiana.
They saw opportunities inside the big cities that they could get factory jobs, and then there could be an opportunity for owning their own businesses.
Stanley continues to farm, but he's also become a teacher, turning the former school building into a museum, welcoming families and children to a forgotten frontier tamed by his forefathers.
How can we survive, and how could we be committed for our families to grow and hand it down to the next generation?
That grit and determination is the story of Lyle Station, a lesson of Black strength and perseverance. In Lyle Station, Dennis Ting.
We want to be recognized for being proud of who we are and where we came from.
WHAS 11 News.
The story of Lyle Station has found itself on a national stage in recent years. The National Museum of African American History and Culture in Washington, D.C. features Lyle Station and is its exhibition on Black rural communities in the Midwest. It also includes several artifacts from the settlement.